Hi guys, welcome to this video series on accounting for IGCSE. The recording of business transactions was originally done in the journal register. But there are certain limitations in using this journal to record your day-to-day transactions. Firstly, it is a repetitive job to record the similar or common entries on a daily basis. For example, there are so many sales and purchase transactions or so many cash and bank transactions in a day. Secondly, if a journal entry is passed for all such transactions on a daily basis, it will waste a lot of time. It is too time consuming to record these transactions in the journal register. Thirdly, it is difficult to locate specific important transactions in a bulky journal. There are high chances of error when posting transactions to the ledger accounts in case transactions are recorded in such a format. So, in order to make the process of recording transactions easy and practical, the original journal is not used in most cases. Instead, separate book of prime entries or subsidiary books are used to record different category of transactions. The original journal is divided into the following book of prime entries. The first book of prime entry is the sales journal or the sales day book. This book will be used to record all transactions involving credit sale of goods. Hence, when goods are sold on credit to debtors, the sale of goods is recorded in this particular book. So the transactions which are specifically excluded from this book include cash sales of goods or sale of anything other than goods, like sale of non-current asset. Such transactions won't be recorded in this book. The second book is the purchase journal, also known as the purchase day book. This book will be used to record transactions involving credit purchases of goods only. When goods are purchased on credit from creditors, that particular transaction will be recorded in this book. So transactions which are specifically excluded from this book are the cash purchases of goods or purchase of anything other than goods. For example, purchase of non-current assets. The third book is the sales returns journal, also known as the sales returns day book. This book is used to record transactions involving return of goods from the customer. When customers return back goods to the business, it is recorded in this particular book. Sales returns is also known as return inwards in accounting. The name is so because goods flow back in the business during a sales returns transaction. Goods are coming inwards. Hence, sales returns is also known as return inwards. Because of this, the sales returns day book is also known as the return inwards day book. The fourth book is the purchase returns journal or the purchase returns day book. This book is used to record transactions involving return of goods back to the supplier or the creditor. Purchase returns is also known as return outwards in accounting because goods are going out of the business. Hence, purchase returns day book is also known as return outward day book. The fifth book is the cash book. This book is used to record all transactions that involve receipt or payment of money in form of cash or through the bank account. In other words, for any transaction, if the business receives money or pays money, that transaction will be recorded in the cash book. This is the reason why cash sales and cash purchases are not recorded in the sales day book and purchase day book. Since they involve receipt and payment of cash, they are recorded in the cash book directly. The sixth book is the petty cash book. At times, the business may maintain a petty cash book in addition to the original cash book. This book is maintained to record petty cash transactions. In other words, small value payments may be recorded in this book and not in the main cash book. And then finally, the business also maintains the journal register. This is the residual book. Any transaction that do not fit in any of the above categories and cannot be recorded in any of these books, they are finally recorded in the journal register. So in this video, we shall see the format of the first four day books, how to prepare them, how to record transactions in these books, and how to post transactions from these books to the ledger accounts. And in the next few videos, we shall see how to prepare the other book of prime entries. The format of these four books is the same. This is the format of the day books. In the date column, record the date of the transaction. In the details column, record the name of the customer or supplier as applicable. Then there is a working column to make discount calculations if any. And finally, the amount column to record the final value of the transactions. Let us try recording some transactions in the sales journal and sales returns journal. So here are some transactions in the books of Henry. Let us try recording these transactions in the sales journal and the sales returns journal. The first transaction, on Jan 12, goods were sold to Jack for $400. So let us record this transaction in the sales day book. Date column, record the date Jan 12. Details column will have the name of the customer, so Jack. The first amount column is the working column if there is a discount. There is no discount in this, so directly record the amount in the final column, 400. On Jan 16, goods were sold to Fredo for 90 and received cash. This is a cash transaction. Sales day book is used to record only credit sale of goods. Hence, cash sales will not be recorded in this book. On Jan 24, goods were sold to Brett at a list price of $1,000, subject to a trade discount of 10%. So in the date column, Jan 24, details will be Brett, name of the customer. Since trade discount is involved, we shall use the first amount column in this. The list price will be written in the first column, 1000. Let's deduct the trade discount at 10%, which works out to 100. And the final amount after the discount is written in the last column, 900. On Jan 28, goods were sold to Jack at a list price of 300, subject to trade discount at 5%. So in the date column, Jan 28, in the details column, Jack, and we shall use the first column again, 300. Let's reduce the trade discount at 5%, which works out to 15, and the difference in the final column, 285. On Jan 29, goods with a list price of 200 were returned by Brett. So this is a sales returns transaction. Let us go to sales returns day book. In the date column, date of the transaction, which is Jan 29. Details column, the name of the customer, Brett. Now one thing that you have to remember here is that when goods were sold, there was a trade discount applicable at the rate of 10%. The same rate of trade discount will also be applicable when goods are returned back by the customer. So list price of the goods 200 written in the first column, less trade discount at 10%, 20. And the final value of sales returns, 180 in the last column. Once these books are prepared for the month, total is taken at the end of the month. So let us take the total. Total sales for January, 1585. And the total sales returns for the month of January will be 180. In the same way, let us record the following transactions in the purchase day book and purchase returns day book. On Jan 8, goods were purchased from Rockwood costing 250, subject to a trade discount of 10%. So in the purchase day book, date column Jan 8, Rockwood, 250 in the first column, deducting the trade discount at 10%, 25, and the net amount will be recorded in the last column, 225. Half of these goods were returned back to Rockwood. This is a purchase returns transaction. Let's record it in the purchase returns day book. Date Jan 15, details Rockwood. List price would be 125, half of what was purchased on Jan 8. Since trade discount was applicable at the time of purchase, same rate of trade discount will also be applicable at the time of purchase returns. The less trade discount at 10%, 12.50, and the net amount 112.50 will be recorded in the last column. On Jan 21, goods were purchased from Lee costing 500. This is a purchase transaction. Let's record in the purchase day book, Jan 21, details column Lee. Since no discount is involved, 500 in the last column. Jan 24, computer purchased from Rockwood costing 600, subject to a trade discount. Now in this case, goods are not being purchased. A computer, which is a non-current asset, is purchased. This book is used to record only purchase of goods, not any other asset. Hence, this transaction will not be recorded in the purchase day book. After all the transactions are recorded, let's take the total at the end of the month. Total purchases for the month, 725, and total purchase returns for the month, 112.50. Once the transactions are recorded to the day books, it is also necessary to learn how to post them to relevant ledger accounts. So from our sales day book and sales returns day book, we can prepare the following accounts. We can prepare a sales account, we can prepare a sales returns account, and we can prepare accounts of various customers. So let us start making the sales account. Now goods were sold on Jan 12, Jan 24 and Jan 28. Ideally transactions should be recorded in the sales account credit side on all these dates. But when a sales day book and a sales returns day book is prepared, transactions are recorded not individually but in total in the sales account and the sales returns account. So the total sales for the month was 1585. So go to the sales account. Sales is an income, so income will be recorded on the credit side, Jan 31. Total sales for January and the total in the amount column 1585. Similarly, the total of sales returns day book was 180. This total will be recorded at the end of the month on the debit side of sales returns account. So Jan 31, total sales returns for January 180. Apart from sales account and sales returns account, we can prepare account of customers. So let us prepare Jack account. Now, in customer's account, transactions are recorded individually. So, on Jan 12, goods were sold to Jack. So, Jack account, debit side, Jan 12. Details will be sales, amount 400. On Jan 24, goods were sold to Brett. So, debit side of Brett account, Jan 24. Details, sales. And in the amount column, the net price after rate discount, which is 900. And then goods were again sold to Jack on Jan 28. So, date Jan 28, details column, sales again. And amount will be the net price after the trade discount, which is 285. On Jan 29, Brett had returned part of the goods. So, this will be recorded on the credit side of Brett account, Jan 29. Details will be sales returns and amount 180. Once the transactions are recorded in the purchase day book and purchase returns day book, they can be posted to the purchase account, purchase returns account, and the accounts of all the suppliers. Let us start making the purchase account. Similar to sales account, purchase account is also recorded in total and not individually. The total of purchase day book was 725. Purchase account is a debit account, so go to the debit side of purchase account, Jan 31. Total purchases for January, 725. Purchase returns account is also recorded in total. Total of purchase returns day book was 112.50. Go to the credit side of purchase returns account, Jan 31. Total purchase returns for January, 112.50. Let us make suppliers account, which is Rockwood and Lee. Rockwood account, on Jan 8, goods were purchased from Rockwood. So credit side, Jan 8. Details will be purchases and the amount after the trade discount, 225. On Jan 15, half of these goods were returned back to Rockwood. So debit side, Jan 15. Details, purchase returns. And in the amount column, the net amount after trade discount, 112.50. Let's make the account of Lee, another supplier. On Jan 21, goods were purchased from Lee costing 500. So credit side of Lee, Jan 21, details would be purchases, 500. If you think that the video is useful, please like the video and share it with others. Kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel to receive notifications when more videos will be uploaded. If you have any feedback regarding the video or you have any doubt regarding this topic, please comment below the video or you may WhatsApp me or email me on the details mentioned.